Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric, and I make apps. Now, today I want to talk about quantity, quality, and getting the reps in. Okay, for the past week or so, we have just had beautiful weather here in England, which is so nice just to be able to get outside and feel the sun on your face, feel the sun on your skin. It just really, really lifts the mood. I love this time of year. So last week I was having a conversation with somebody, like a younger person. When I say younger, I mean like early 20s, about YouTube videos. So this was somebody who wants to do YouTube videos professionally and which I think is hard. I think, every YouTuber I've ever met, and I met quite a few who do it professionally, they don't make a lot of money. They find a hard time just getting the advertising revenue and everything too. A bit similar to us app developers, actually. So, yeah, but I think it's a hard existence, but I guess it's doable. So I asked him when was the last time he posted, and he said it's been about 4 months since his last post. He knows that's too long, and he knows he needs to get another post out there, but he's had trouble getting the motivation up to do it. And I've had this conversation with a lot of people, either business owners who want to do videos for their business, or people who just want to make money from YouTube. And what I usually say is, dude, I'm doing it every day. It was a difficult decision to do the daily one, but if I could do it every day, you could do it once a week, or you could even, or especially once a month, or especially, once. I think anybody who runs a business should be doing some video, right? And usually when I say that, I get two responses. I get one is flattering and one is a bit insulting. The flattering one goes like this: "Oh yeah, but Eric, you're really good on camera," right? Which is ridiculous, because if you saw my early videos, you wouldn't say that, right? It just took a bit of practice. And the more insulting reason is, "Yeah, but Eric, your videos are kind of eh, and I want mine to be like really high quality. You go for quantity, but I want quality," right? Which is funny. We hear this a lot about, quantity versus quality. A lot of times with apps too, I think, people will say, "Why don't you do fewer apps? Just do like one or two really good ones rather than do a whole bunch of applications." And it's just usually it's said by people who don't have any apps, right? This weekend I finished listening to an audiobook. I mean, it's a book also. You've probably seen it, Atomic Habits by James Clear. Hey, I highly recommend that book. A really, really good book. It was recommended to me last week, and I devoured it on the audiobook in the gym. So, but there's one story in Atomic Habits which he talks about quality and quantity, and it really solidified it for me. It made me feel a little less self-conscious about producing too much. The whole quality versus quantity thing. They talked about a study that was done at a university, a photography class, where they took half the class and they told them to focus on quantity. So produce as for the best grade, you have to push as produce as many pictures as you can, or take as many pictures as you can by the end of the course. And the other half had to do just one picture, but it had to be the highest quality, like the best picture they could take. And he said consistently, the ones that focus on quantity took the better pictures than those who did quality, because the ones who did quality were just constantly worried about doing the best, and they would never actually do anything. And that spoke a lot to me, because we talked to a lot of, I mean, over the course of my life, I've talked to a lot of people who talk a good game. They say what you should be doing. Hey, you know what you should do? You should do this, you should do that. But they're not doing anything, right? And there was a really good term that he used in the book. He talked about getting the reps in. The same as if you're at the gym, you have to get the reps in. You can't focus on quality until you learn how to do the craft. Like an app developer who only does one app and learns how to code one app is not going to be as good a coder as somebody who's constantly churning stuff out, whether or not they actually release it, right? Or a writer who doesn't write anything, but he's going to sit down and write his masterpiece one day, and he doesn't churn stuff out. If you read books by writers like Stephen King wrote a really good book on writing, where he talked about the daily craft of writing, and you have to put those numbers out, and you have to just produce, produce, produce. It's not all going to be good, but you have to produce. I just want to talk a little bit about that today, because a lot of times as app developers, as the videos too, you get criticized every so often. Why don't you raise the quality? But I think you need to focus on quantity before you can focus on quality. You have to put the reps in. Ideally, the reps would be high quality reps, but they have to be reps all the same. There are those who do, and there are those who talk. And those who do. So let me know what you guys think. You guys might disagree with me. You guys might think quality is what it's all about. Right? Just do it once, but do it perfect the first time. I just don't think that's possible. What do you guys think? Anyway, that is it for today. I will talk to you guys again tomorrow.